Let's add another state to delete our to-do. This should be pretty simple, in fact, and conceptually, it's going to be we want to move into a state where we delete the to-do. If it errors, do something. If it succeeds, go back and refetch the to-dos and make sure everything's all working. And what I'm going to do is just, I'd like you to pause the video and see if you can implement it yourself using a service, probably using an assign, using kind of the errors that we have here, and see what you come up with. So pause the video now. Okay, this is how I would implement it. What we're going to do is from the to-dos loaded state, we're going to need a delete event. So we delete some to-do and we end up in the deleting state. So deleting to-do state. So, whoops, I need to open the to-do app machine to make sure my changes get saved. So when we delete the to-do, we're going to need to pass along with it an ID or kind of which to-do it is we want to delete. Because we're using a set, we know that the to-dos are unique. So this delete event, which should be, let's see, deleting to-do, delete. Yeah, here we go. Here's our delete. So the delete event up here, I'm going to add it to the union. Type delete, and then to-do is going to be a string. So the deleting to-do, we're going to need to add an invoke. Source, delete to-do. This is going to be, it's going to return void, I think, so similar to save to do. So data void, delete to do. And then when it's, so when it's errored, so what do we do when it's errored? I guess we go into a deleting to do errored state. Yeah, I think so. So this is kind of like a design decision, basically. So we need to change this to invocation error, deleting to do errored, probably, yeah, in fact, I've got an idea for this. We'll look at it in a minute. But when we're done, we need to then go back into the loading to do state and reload them all. So done, delete to do. In fact, I'll put this up here. So this makes this line a bit nicer. So the delete goes here and then click and drag, move all that stuff up there. So we now need to implement our delete to-do function where we go into index.tsx and say delete to-do async. We're going to grab context and event. And this one is interesting here because here the event we receive is the delete event and it's got the to-do right on it. So we can say to-dos dot, it's delete, I think, event dot day. Yeah, it is event dot to-do. Thank you, GitHub Copilot. So we now need to, when we're in the correct state, add in the delete button here for each to-do. And let's say that we have a, in fact, I'm gonna start with state.context.todos.map. And for each to-do, this, or all the, these are the to-dos that are in our context. We have our to-do here, which I'm gonna wrap in a P. And then I'm going to say, we're going to add a button to delete it. And this button is going to be on click. We're going to send an event of type delete. And the to-do is going to be the to-do that we get from our map here. So now we can go back into here. We've got our take bins out. In fact, I'm just going to turn this into a display flex. So we'll go, not class name, I'm not using Tailwind. Style equals display flex and align items center. And yeah, okay. So take bins out. When we delete it, it should remove take bins out from our context up there. So let's see if it does that. Yes, it does. Do laundry up there. Brilliant. And that's, let's simulate what's going on there. So we load the to-dos. We're finished loading them. We go into the to-dos loaded state. We enter the delete up there. We delete the to-do. Boom, loading to-dos, and we're good to go. Fantastic. So what happens if we error then? So let's throw an error inside here. Oh no. We're probably going to need to do the same thing as we did with the other error handlers, which is assign the error to context. So let's go into the do at machine. Where's the thing that we need to add? Error delete to do. Oh, whoops, I'm in simulate mode. So deleting to do errored actions. Assign, where is it? Assign error to context. So context, save that. That gets added to our diagram, lovely. So if we now delete this, we should see the oh no error is in there and we're in the deleting to do errored state. Very cool. So that might be different to your interpretation. You might have added like a confirmation step in there. But here we've just got a relatively simple way of deleting to-dos on the database. I think, yeah, we'll look at this, how to handle this properly in the next video.